Joining us now to talk about the results and the bigger picture here, Republican strategist Kevin Eckery and our Democratic strategist Jason Kinney. So thank you both for joining us. It is Super Tuesday. Is this super for anyone? The fact we're still talking about four candidates, is that a problem tonight for the GOP?
Well, I mean, on the funny side, I can't tell if today is Super Tuesday or Groundhog Day. I mean, it's just been going on and on and on. But it really is sort of the end of the first phase. I mean, remember, we began with 11 candidates. Now we have four. And everybody won a prize, so it's kind of like a kid's birthday party today. And we're going to have four tomorrow and four for quite a while longer.
Well, I think if you're a Democrat, this is a Super Tuesday. I mean, once again, Mitt Romney, with every financial advantage in the world, has been handed the ball on the one-yard line and is unable to stick it into the end zone. There were three battleground states going into today. He's already lost two. He's behind in the third, behind to a candidate who couldn't even get his act together to do the paperwork to get on the ballot everywhere in that state. In the places he has won, it's been a plurality, not a majority, except in his home state, which means a majority of Republicans are voting against
Mitt Romney.
Well,
and a large majority in Virginia today, and he's going to win.
Well, not as big as it should have been.
And by far, a majority of the delegates in Ohio today, regardless, because, as you say, Santorum couldn't be bothered with the paperwork. So,
well, there is that issue there.
And incredibly low turnout in every one of these primaries, record low turnout in Virginia, record low turnout in some of the other states that we're looking at. There's a huge enthusiasm gap here, and it's not just going to affect the presidential race on the Republican side. I think it's going to affect everything up and down the ballot, Congress, Senate, Assembly, everything.
So it's kind of a nail biter right now. We're looking at Ohio. Why is Ohio so important? And what happens if Romney doesn't win?
If Romney doesn't win, that's okay. I mean, the more importantly is for Santorum is what if Santorum, you know, doesn't win? I mean, this is some place where Santorum was really pinning all of his hopes. With respect to Romney, I mean, he just has to be close in Ohio because it's more conservative, and it's tailor-made for Santorum, supposedly, in terms of conservative Catholic vote, people who are more responsive to the social conservative message. But I think we just have to see.
Well, hold on. This is a mixed bag, and it's also a bellwether state. No Republican who has lost Ohio has gone on to win the presidential race.
Yeah, but that's in the general election, not in the primaries.
Yeah, okay, and he's got to win Ohio. If he can't get a majority of Republicans to vote for him, how's he ever going to get a majority of Americans?
So
voters?
Let's kind of pull it out of the inside baseball stuff and talk about exit polling.
Sure.
A lot of the voters here saying, once again, the economy is the most important thing to us. Gas prices really top of mind. And the thing they want most in their GOP candidate is someone who can beat President Obama.
Well, if they want somebody who can beat President Obama, then you're going to vote for Mitt Romney. If you want somebody, you know, who won't, then you've got three other candidates to choose from. I mean, it's really that simple.
And yet Mitt Romney has repeatedly failed to beat three candidates that everyone in the world agrees are fatally flawed and can't win the presidency.
He still has the most votes. He still has the most delegates. And this is when proportional representation and a beauty contest, this is what happens.
And so the delegates are split up. We kind of look at these as who wins what state, but we have to remember that in the proportionate states, yeah. So, Jason, while we're talking to you, what do you make of President Obama coming out today and stealing some of the thunder, taking some of those headlines with a big news conference?
Well, I think it was a nice reminder that first of all, President Obama, no one has more momentum behind him right now than President Obama. The economy's turning around, his numbers are going up, and he still is president at a time where, and it was a nice reminder just how far to the right these Republican candidates have gotten and how damaging this contested, brutal primary has been on all of their numbers. The unfavorables on all four candidates are at an all-time high, and President Obama had a great moment today. I thought it was perfectly appropriate.
And it was a heads-up play. I mean, he wanted to get in the news cycle, remind everybody he's the president. If I were working for him, I would have advised him doing exactly the same thing.
Thank you both for sharing your insight, Kevin Eckery and Jason Kinney.